A sorrowful story, quite far from mundane, is that which befell poor Michael McShane. The weakest of boys, a helpless young child, his two other brothers, both brutishly wild. They poked him and hit him, and his herd oft did tease.
That dumb little Michael, oh how you displease!
One day they decided it would be quite the treat to pick up his hands and take hold of his feet. Then drag him outside to Papa's old tin shed, where lying in wait was a sight one should dread. Its door was ajar for poor Michael to see. What it was filled his brothers with such evil glee. A vault meant for food, but now for a midge. A tiny white coffin, the old family fridge. They stuffed him inside and ram shut the door. One brother he laughed, the other laughed more. The terrified cries of poor Michael McShane went completely ignored by the two inhumane. So time slowly passed with the brothers on shutter, Michael's shouts dying down to a half-hearted mutter. And then, out of nowhere, a strange thing occurred. The small boy's faint sobbing was no longer heard. The brothers, they paused in waiting for more, but no sound was coming from the cold white fridge door. With patience now thin, "Roy-o!" said one brat. He rolled up his sleeves, turned his head left and spat. Then using his strength, he pushed the old block till it fell on its side, breaking ope its lock.
"Get out here!"
they shouted, pulling back the fridge door. But once they did that, their grins were no more. For Michael McShane, you see, was not there. No trace could be found, not a single brown hair. For weeks people searched, but nobody knew what it was that had happened, so the searchers withdrew. Now see the two brothers, their eyes wide with fright. Tucked into their beds, they can't sleep at night. For Michael McShane, he visits their dreams. In a shallow white box, he cries, muffled screams.